Tulsa King, first released in 2022 and can be seen in 2024 on Paramount Plus. The second season is coming, and you should catch up on Sly's latest.
I kept my mouth shut for 25 years.
I don't know what you're expecting. Now that you're back,
I'm expecting adequate compensation.
Tulsa.
What's Tulsa?
I want you to go there. The horse race, the Springboard Mile. There's nobody doing nothing. You can do whatever you want.
Not exactly the welcome I was expecting.
Name's Tyson. Welcome to Tulsa.
$2,000 a week. You drive for me now. What crew runs this neighborhood?
No crew up in here. We're in the middle of nowhere.
What'll it be?
I assume you don't have Keontae.
You assume correctly.
I wouldn't have pegged you as the Boy Scout.
Why not? This wasn't necessary. What is that place?
It's a dispensary.
Oh my God, is he dead?
No, he's taking a break. This is how it's gonna work. I'll protect you from the gangs.
What gangs?
And the law.
This is legal.
You gotta know your risk.
There was no risk until you came along.
Ever heard of Black McAdam? It's a motorcycle gang.
You're overplaying your hand.
When I play my hand, you won't see it coming.
Any flammable liquids or firearms?
In the box? Nah.
This situation is not going to be controllable for much longer.
You got a pretty good appetite for someone who was just shot at.
If I stopped eating every time somebody tried to hurt me, I'd be a skeleton. I want to be up front with you. It could get ugly.
Is Nero in the mafia?
Nah, there's no such a thing.
Is this a one-off? Or one of many?
Too soon to tell.
If you're thinking this is an unlikely place to put Sylvester Stallone, you might be right. Well, his character, a mobster, just out after 25 years of faithful service in the federal pen, is sent or vanquished to Tulsa, Oklahoma, to make him less of a threat to the boys in New York. Well, they didn't think that much of this 70-something mobster, and that's where the fun begins. As you might think, Sylvester Stallone dominates the screen when he's there, but creator Taylor Sheridan, along with a host of episode directors, put together an able cast. Jay Will appearing early on as his able sidekick and driver. Andrea Savage is his off and on again FBI agent, double agent, trying to keep her job. And then there are the performances by Martin Starr, whose character is just trying to keep a legal pot shop running before Manfredi comes to town and takes over. Our hero also wants to reconnect with his daughter and grandchildren, and that gets us to the family portion of this drama. The bad guys in the first season are led by Dominic Lombardozzi and Richie Koster. This is worth your subscription. CBS decided to run the first season as a late summer filler before season 2 starts back on Paramount Plus in September. But this action-packed story of family, loyalty, often misplaced, deception, fun, but a lot of violence, is one of producer-writer Taylor Sheridan's tricks. Even Michael Beach gets a shot here. He's in 2 Sheridan shows so far, along with his role in SWAT. Again, he appears as a father, this time to Manfredi's driver, Tyson. This is not all violence, but a good-looking character, and each episode moves right along. Hang on for season 2. Tulsa King, first premiered in 2024, can be seen now, and first premiered in 2022, can be seen now in 2024 on Paramount Plus. 9 of 10 stars. UNFROSTED, released in 2024, can be seen on Netflix. You folks born after 1970 won't get this, but relax for the ride and laughs anyway.
Hardly invented a shelf-stable fruit pastry breakfast product.
No.
Yeah.
Boy.
It's Post. They did it.
I'm about to finally crush that big red K that never stops glaring at me. How do you think Post did it?
There's always a surprise inside the box.
I wonder if they use xanthan gum.
Xanthan. Kellogg's is entering the race to reinvent breakfast with the help of Steve Schwinn, Chef Boyardee, and Jack LaLanne.
They're stacking the deck with ringers.
You know Isaiah Lamb from Quaker?
You Kellogg's people.
We're about to have some very powerful people very upset.
You have to win. Are you making any progress?
It's not to scale, but...
What are you guys, 5 years old? Little John John draws better than that. And I think there's something wrong with him.
Nobody said this was gonna be easy.
We're talking about happy childhoods for millions of American kids. The important thing is the name.
Fruit Magoos! What?
No.
Heat 'em up and eat 'em ups.
No sale.
Oblong nibblers.
Is this a joke?
Whoever gets to the shelves first is gonna win this thing.
Give up the tarts, old man!
How did it get this far?
It's breakfast. Things happen.
Isn't this a cereal company? Why did my husband explode?
I enjoyed this 90-minute history lesson in the morning cereal business of the 60s. Long before the choices we all enjoy these days, there was only two companies that dominated the market, Post and Kellogg's. I'm a brand crunch guy these days. Nighttime TV, at least late-night TV, was dominated by Johnny Carson, and Tony the Tiger made everything great in the morning, but someone had to be the winner, and the execs were always looking for something new. This time it's Trap Tops, whatever. This comedy by Jerry Seinfeld and a host of stars, including Jim Gaffigan, Hugh Grant as the semi-bad guy Tony the Tiger, Amy Schumer, and Max Greenfield, make this must-see TV. It's a lot of fun, and I'd watch it again. Well-filmed and written, it's worth your subscription. Unfrosted, released in 2024 on Netflix. 10 of 10 stars.